Hey guys, my name is Nilesh Kadia, and if you don't know me, I am second year resident in the Department of Prosthodontics at Government Dental College, Ahmedabad, and this is my fourth day of isolation. I have been diagnosed COVID positive, and along with me in another room, my another colleague is also having isolation. So today I will be asking 20 most commonly asked questions by you guys to him. His name is Dr. Kunjit Marwa. He got 99th rank in NEET MDS 2021. He was second in his state, that is Madhya Pradesh, and he got 17th rank in AIMS. He has completed his BDS from SDM Dental College, Dharwad, Karnataka. He is now doing his prostho residency in second year in Government Dental College, Ahmedabad, along with me. I also have provided Instagram and Facebook links to his account in the description, so you also can ask him your questions directly. Let's get started.
When I started my preparation, I used to study around about 2-3 hours, that too after clinics, because I was doing my internship. Later, I could actually give around 16 to 17 hours. That is the bare minimum you need to sacrifice. I had joined series coaching classes during my internship. For the first 7-8 months, I was in satellite center, followed by I shifted to Davangiri in a live center. January mid. 15th of Jan around about, I started my coaching as well as my preparation from Jan. Medical subjects was always a challenging task, but for me, as I had joined CDs, sir had given us a very nice cumulative notes plus dental pulse and few diagrams here and there from for general medicine, physiology, and all that would do the task. So basic is always pulse. I started doing pharmac from Sparsh Gupta. In Sparsh Gupta, everything is very nicely, very easily, and very concisely given. It has a detailed explanation for everything and a classification in all the important topics. Following Sparsh Gupta, you can always read your pulse. Dental pulse is more than enough if you study thoroughly. If you don't just study the MCQ, that's not sufficient. You should have a detailed idea of the synopsis and the explanation line by line. In fact, you should study as many times as possible, because everything will be given there and everything will ultimately come from dental pulse. Preparation from third or final year doesn't make sense. I would just suggest to all the aspirants that from third and final year, just be in the class, study daily, improve your concepts and read the standard textbooks. That's all. I had followed religiously CDs test series itself. I did not join any other test series. Reading standard textbook during PG preparation is not advisable at all, because you need to revise what you have studied before your NEET exam. So I would just suggest that you should read your pulse or any other MCQ book and the previous year papers with your coaching notes. That's more than enough. I had revised pulse around 12 to 13 times and my notes as well as my pink papers also. So revision is actually the key. So you need to revise as many times as possible. For me, notes was dental pulse. Yeah, I just used to add whatever new I think that is important that is not given in pulse. I used to add it in my pulse by sticky notes or writing down the points, jotting down the points. Yeah, so basically you don't need notes when you have dental pulse. For picture-based question, I used to follow the series app, the daily boosters and whatever was given in that. Moreover, we had this chapter in the Pulse that has picture-based questions, and then you can also see all the latest instruments from your standard period textbook, say ortho textbook, all the pliers and all. You can just go through it, the Adams clasp and everything. You can just have a look. Moreover, you can, for an art, you have to study each and every diagram very nicely, because they can just label anything and they can ask you what this is. So an art textbook is very important for diagrams. I used to do around about 200 to 300 MCQs per day without fail. And it's not just about doing the MCQs, you should also read the explanation. One MCQ, if you do, it will teach you one MCQ. If you do one MCQ with another explanation of it, you will be able to read at least 20 MCQs with that. To manage my stress, I used to take equally spaced breaks in between. After say 3-3.5 hours of studying, I used to take a half an hour or 1 hour break, in which I used to watch my favorite series like Friends, How I Met Your Mother, all whatever you like, you can watch. You can talk to your friends, you can talk to your parents, you can do anything which makes you feel light, makes you feel stress-free, makes you feel relaxed. The best MCQ book is undoubtedly The Dental Pulse. For the new edition, it will have all the recent advances, recent questions and recent patterns. To complete your syllabus, firstly, what I did was to start early. I started during my Jan mid. Moreover, then I was consistent. Whatever may come, I used to spare at least 2-2.5 hours daily for studying. Moreover, I used to study during my clinical hours. Whenever I didn't have patients, I used to read. According to me, coaching plays a very crucial role during your preparation, because it sets a base, what to study, what not to study. They have the experience of the previous year papers, how has it been asked, what is the pattern. And so you need something like that, like a base, and then self-study is the most important. The most important thing when you are feeling down or when you are feeling low is, don't compare with your colleagues, your friends, your roommate. Don't compare. Talk to someone who makes you feel good. Talk to someone who can cheer you up. Listen to motivational songs. Listen to motivational quotes. Take a break and get back studying. Final year BDS is a nightmare for everyone. It subjects together so much of syllabus. So all you need to do is have a equally spaced timetable. You should have everything. You should be completely organized. Should be completely organized, and you should read daily as much as you can. At least 2 hours you can spare, and you can read one subject or the other, whatever you like. And from the start, if you do, final year is not very difficult. Revision is actually the key. You should revise as many times as possible. So for that, you should first study very limited. You should study what is required and what is being asked. You should study, you should know what to study and what not to study. Moreover, first time you study and the second time you revise, the speed always keeps getting very, very faster by each consecutive revision. So don't worry about that. You will be able to revise the number of times you want and the number of times you can sacrifice.
Okay guys, so I hope you liked the video. If you have any queries, any suggestions, any doubts, you can ask me or Dr. Gunjit Marwa. I have already said, I have provided the link of his Instagram page in the description, so you may check that out. Thank you.